Hey guys, so got me another little project. This is a rather easier repair. It's a pilot bit or a stinger bit, or I don't know what they call them. There are all kinds of names for them, for an auger for foundation drilling. And what happened here, of course, it looks like they busted off the back side of this pocket. But this one is slightly different. This one here, it looks like it was all cast as one piece. It looks to be, at least. I can't see, unless they did a fantastic job blending those welds in, but I don't see why they would. Another interesting note is that this point and this point, they all travel in different circles, so they cut it differently. So I have to watch that when I put it back on there. But being as this is a singular piece of cast, I think, that's so hard to tell, I'm going to attempt to torch it off as well. And you may have to use a gouger up in this area here to try and remove it, and have to chop up this guy here to make it fit right in there. So hang tight, and we'll see what we can do with this. Alright, so what I'm going to try to do is I'm going to try and torch in the downward direction. Hopefully to be able to wipe off most of this and then get an idea as to where I'm going with a torch and how much to cut off. I'm going to cut off this little edge here just for kicks and see if I can install that tooth back in there, just to kind of get an idea of the distances between the points, so I can have a reference when I put it back. So let me do that first. Something like that. And get a tape measure. solid chunk, all right. That up a bit. Let's see. That might work. That does. All right, let me move it around. So for that. Alright, so it's about as clean as I can get it for now. And now I'll have to trim this guy up. I'll probably cut this guy right here. Cut that off. Just stick that on right there. And make sure I get my measurements from here to here to here to here. And that should be good. Alright, next step. Alright, so the next step is going to be to make this pocket fit that spot. And so I will be making a cut here to cut that excess off and then cut this here. You may need a little preheat, that way it's a nice clean cut. Normally this type of cast or these castings are really good steel. So they cut very well. Now it's up to me to cut it well or good. All right, we'll see. A little preheat helps. To keep the tip away from it because it's going to hit that. Turn this guy around. Something like that. Okay, not bad. Okay, let me get set up. So I often get asked if welding or grounding onto my truck bed affects the electronics or the computer and the battery. And fortunately, for these past two rigs that I've run, I haven't had any issues. And one of the things I think that may lend to making it easier is to try and keep your ground as short as possible, right? You don't want to ground the other end of the truck and then be welding over here. So that's what I'm doing. It's connected directly to the vise and the ground creates a circuit through there. So for those of you that have wondered about that, I haven't had any issues in all these years, and I've had two trucks with flatbeds like this. So all right, moving on. In case you're wondering whether that's clean enough, they got all the slag off of it and from the torch mill scale, so it's clean enough. It's no need to be spending all kinds of time just making sure it's all nice and smooth. It works fine. Same thing with this. Most of this stuff will come right off. It'll be okay. This is gonna, I don't know exactly which way I'm gonna put it, that way or that way or whatever the case, but just as long as these points that I took measurements off of come out at the same spot. One of the current concerns I do have though is that this is a little bit heavier on this side here as a protection, and I do need to make sure that it points out far enough so as it rubs it clears enough. As this tooth cuts the dirt or the rock, that it clears enough room for this to clear itself so it just doesn't continue to rub smooth. So let's see where we're at. Back a little bit around there, around there. Well, that's almost it. But actually that's not enough. I need to do it this way. Break that off. I guess I'll put it this way and just have to lean it out just a little bit more. The force on this tooth is naturally coming out this way, so I might be able to get away with doing it like that so that the strength of this pocket will hold on a little bit longer. Let's see. At least I know I can tack it at the bottom. Dum-dum. Little tack pack. Okay, it's come out a lot. Let's go out some more. spoke too much. This left is good. Now it's good. It's a little out, but that'll clear that pocket. Yeah, I think I'm gonna leave that at that. Just looking at it vertically, you can kind of see the edge of this carbide that clears the edge of this pocket as it comes around. And they're about the same height. Okay, well, I left myself a huge gap over here. Well, it is what it is. Mortar weld. There we go. Need a camera with zoom on it. You guys are about that far away from me. Yeah, really close. How can I get you guys closer without being in the way? Let's try that. Okay, so it's running a little cold, so I'm turned it up a little bit. It's at 104 amps and now I got 107 amps. Hopefully I can do this pass decent enough. Got the shakes, I'm hungry or something. I don't know what's going on. Either way, there you go. smooth enough. It'll work.
Actually, I don't like it, but it's enough. Okay, other side.
If you notice on this side, I cut off way too much. There was some buildup from in here that I was torching in this direction. I said, no, let me cut it off straight. That way I have more opportunity to put this piece closer. I guess it would have been better had I not beveled this side, but there's a whole lot of weld to fill in here now. So, it is what it is. And so here we go.
Thank you. Okay.
I'll do a few more passes.
Do a pass here. Do a pass here, and then run this one last along the bottom. Okay. Yeah, let me see. We'll see.
Whoa. see it.
Let me turn it over one more time, weld the bottom, and that's it.
Alright, well, I finished this guy up. Pretty standard repair. Still a little warm. I know I've shown you this before, or these types of repairs before. Came out alright. Same thing here. You know, these are just an everyday type of thing that has to get fixed. I know the last one I showed you was a little bit too far away as distance, so hopefully this one shows enough welding in the with the lens on that I got. And so now I'm off to the next one. Nice little project. As I mentioned, this one was kind of interesting because it was an all cast piece, but we got it fixed up. So thanks for the follow, and hope you guys enjoyed it, and we'll catch you guys on the next one.